We're going to be going to the game in just a second. For the other players that I know, I believe Bird is actually a TF2 player as well that Mangachu brought in. He has replaced Dump Truck, also who goes by Exion in the game.
Oh, that's right.
It's actually been
truck.
It's been rather well for it's gone pretty good for NG Red since making the trade. Chance actually is not the player
the
that in the game.
He's
not the
rapper.
It is not the owner of NG Red. It is not the Quake player that no one knows. And he is actually a StarCraft player. He was a mid-tier but sponsored, haha, StarCraft player. StarCraft 2 player, that is, back in 2009, 2011. That he was okay. And his transition to tank, I think, has been pretty good. But I also question the move from Chronic to Chance. I think Chronic has actually played really well on one shot. And... you know, NG Red has had some okay results. They have pushed teams to the limit. They can definitely win this series here.
Had to give Chronic a chance. I'm just here to ruin the cast every once in a while.
You're doing the exact opposite. You're making this cast everything it needs to be. Well, I mean, Bird has played the best for them over the last probably week, though. He's been amazing. He's been a great addition to their roster, especially on Soldier 76, who we've seen enter this meta so strong with the nerfs to McCree, the nerf to Widow, the consistent distance damage out of Soldier 76 has been absolutely crucial. So much so that we're probably going to see it on defense here. Of note on the defense as well, Harblue's Roadhog's been really good. They're going to run that on defense. Nicholas on Junkrat is going to be really strong. They're going to also run a Symmetra, and Torque is going to run on that 76 too. So I imagine you see 76 on Cafe, Nicholas spamming all over the place, Harbu looking for picks, and a lot of it is going to depend on if Joe Meister can do what Flame did and get that teleporter up really early.
One of the players we still haven't mentioned is Wolf, who is one of their main DPS on NG Raid, and he's more of a pub star that got really popular playing matchmaking and just playing a lot during the closed beta. And he's had a really good Widow, a really good McCree, and he will have to do work on Genji if NG Red is going to want to break the defense in this series.
And it looks like they took the backfield pretty early, surrounding them completely. No frags really going for either team right now. Just a lot of heals going around. We actually have JKW almost has his ultimate already on Reinhardt, which is pretty darn fast. We might even be seeing that Symmetra teleporter come up in the next couple of moments here. Not sure how long a moment is, but he has a few of them.
Yeah, what both those things mean to me is that the offense took way too much chip and chunk damage early on. The fact that JK is almost at 100% Earth Shatter means someone was eating Fire Strikes, and that teleporter is about to go down means the exact same thing. They also got picked really early there as they didn't account for Harblue coming in the back line, so a really bad first push coming in.
Oh, Harblue up top grabs Mangachu, puts him down. Just
second time.
A Roadhog hanging around up top getting those one picks. And they're probably not even going to want to push this, though it looks like they're still going for it anyway. They have Bird with the damage boost hiding behind Chance. Harblue takes down another, and they're going to have to back up. They know they have to back up because they've taken two losses before this fight's even gone down. Harblue, really the star player right now, who has probably gotten the only kills this entire game so far.
Yeah, it's the second time he did that to Mangachu. This could not have started any worse for NG Red right now. They've given up every ult that they shouldn't have. Both their first pushes have been
Harblue tiny. Grabs nap time. The Mercy goes down. There's a third for him. The MVP up there coming down, trying to stop some more people. Chance walking backwards, and this is going to be another failed push. And grabs another person. Bird goes down to Harblue. He is just carrying this defense right now.
I mean, NG Red was able to kill the teleporter from Mangachu, but Joe Meister, to start that fight, got two kills on Symmetra with one ball, and if that's going to happen, they're not going to be able to make things work. Good news is, for NG Red, out of everything, the teleporter is down.
Oh, Harbu.
And they have five ults, so they want to make something happen. They can. Harbu gets a kill. Joe Meister with one. Harbu with another. Harbu is going off in this game. Chance cannot
that
get
is
away.
A squad kill for Harbu right there. He has done everything. He has been there every single time Mangachu has tried to get in, fly in. He gets the hook, put him down, and then followed up with the ultimate, cleaning up the entire team. And they're going to have 2 minutes left to get this push. They might have to change something up if they really want to be able to get this.
Well, at least now they're forced into the slasher strategy of everyone get your alts and everyone use them at once to win this team fight, because that's exactly what they're going to do now, but it's been so sloppy.
You're going to sound barrier and speed boost in. Wolf uses sword. Bird uses attack, and they should be able to win this team fight. Bird get two. Harbu is able to respond with one. But Chance Wolf with another big res comes
out. Might be able to come through this teleporter right now in just a second when they all revive. Another revive comes through. If anyone goes down, teleporter is there. No one's going to the backfield to get it. It looks like Mangachu's finally decided to put it down. Bad timing. The Mercy comes out of the teleporter and goes down. It looks like this is going to be the successful push that they needed, where they did just use all of their ultimates. We'll have to see how that carries on to the second point, though.
Yeah, they needed all six ults to make that work, and Mangachu barely found the teleporter at the very end of that team fight, but at least they were able to get the first checkpoint. And I think if you're NG Red, that was at least what you had to do. I mean, the better teams, you only want to use a few of your ults to take a team fight and try to conserve them for the rest of the map, and NG Red were like, no, we're going to use six now and make sure that we don't lose this. And even then, it was still pretty close at the end.
Lucio missed the elevator, does not know the speed strats, didn't get one cycle, trying to get on top of the roof right now with the rest of his friends. Shake and Nicolisto? Is he just call him Nicholas or Nicolisto?
It's Nicholas, because TGO is like a clan tag, that's why
that's not a J, that's an I, it's Nicolisto, yeah. Shut up.
Star spoken, I got it.
There's name changes available, if he doesn't like it, you'll change it. I love that the elevator strats, like, you have to wait for the elevator. We see JKW trying to get back up on top. You can have Mangachu try and fly in here and try and push a couple people off again. He actually does get two of them. Don't make it up to the roof, so you have 76 and Lucio down on the low ground. Reinhardt jumps down as well, trying to chase down there Lucio away from the cart. Limousine not making it too far, but Chance coming around the side. They might actually be able to get a chance here. Mangachu up top. It looks like they lost that high ground altogether, but Nicolisto gonna destroy him before he even gets a chance to ult.
Well, they're almost in that situation again where they have every single ult and they're gonna hit all of their Qs. Torque is able to take down Wolf pretty early here. They're really reestablishing themselves on this roof. We're gonna see what Hardblue can do. He's been such a chaotic force, not only on his Roadhog, but now with his Winston. He gets in early, disrupts everyone, and Nicholas able to clean that up over the top as Chance does finally punish Hardblue, but that's gonna stall out this push.
I mean, Gale Force really has been dominating this game. And yes, NG Red has all six ults besides Mangachu, who will have his very quickly, but they cannot be winning, let alone this map, but a series or this tournament, if they're going to need all six ults to be winning a team fight.
Well, they're actually really aggressive right there, gotten into everybody's faces on those rooftops up there, and Mangachu with the damage boost is going to be the one trying to go around, but he gets taken out of the sky because the ground cracked. Don't get it. But that's going to be another successful hold there for just a second. Nicolisto up top. Wolf is on the Mercy, trying to take him down, but everybody in the world is chasing him right now. They're just too split up right now to have a successful fight.
Mangachu in the back, huge barrage, only gets one, does get Shake of the one, but it's still not going to be enough to win the team fight. Nap time goes down in the end. And after using four of the six alts for NG Red, the cart went backwards. And that is not the way that they want things to go. That allows Gale Force, East Force to regain control of the top of the saloon. Joe Meister still has sound barrier. And things are not looking good here for NG Red. More than likely, Gale Force is going to go down. They will. Joe Meister's still holding on to sound barrier. Now he uses it. Huge opportunity for them to get kills. Nicholas with one, JKW with one, and a second. A fourth for Torque. That is going to be a full team wipe. For Gale Force against NG Red.
What's going on with the offenses on Hollywood second stage, and what are teams missing that they need to bring into this? Is it just mechanics? Are they compositionally challenged? Do you think they should be running Winstons and Divas to really force this high ground issue? I mean, this is the second time we've seen teams absolutely struggle on second point offense.
I think Winston is a very good option. I think, you know, that the tank play that we've seen and gaining control of the high ground is important. I think another thing to keep in mind is we saw Envy go through Hollywood really quickly. So it might be just more that these teams are not playing as good as the top teams.
It definitely looks like coordination, as every time these fights start, it just devolves into a barroom brawl, and they happen all over the place, and everyone's hitting every button, and then just kind of who comes out on top tends to be the defense, as they're the ones that are able to react to the initiations and kind of use their ults secondarily.
I think NG Red actually started off really strong, but after that maybe got a little bit frustrated and just started running in. After they used all their ultimates and it didn't go their way, they just have been a little bit all over the place with no clear plan in mind. A little bit of a Farrah air fight going on up in the sky, and Callisto throwing down on Mangachu, and that's going to be a chance trying to come in for the final overtime here, but I don't think he's going to be able to make a difference with Wolf throwing out the Death Blossom, not even killing a single person because of the break it down by Lucio. That's that.
Yeah, that is that. And really, none of this game was solid from NG Red. I'm gonna disagree with you, Stir. It didn't go well at all.
I think
all six ults to even take the point, and it barely happened.
No, I think their first push on the second point, it looked like they were ready and they were organized, and it was the best push they had, and after that, it was a little bit more downhill. But yeah, for sure, even pushing the first point, they struggled a bit. I think it was a little bit of stubbornness on their side. They didn't change their strategy a single time. I don't think they changed characters very much, even though it was consistently Harblue that was stopping them
on
the top of the roof every time.
Man of the first half is definitely Harblue, holding it down for Gale Force, especially on that first point and the second point, to be completely honest. He did a lot of work, and Gale Force looking solid to start out this tournament. NG Red, not solid at all. And really, the point I make earlier is, I don't know if it's necessarily these teams not being able to go through Hollywood as it is. These teams are not able to make the offense work, or probably the defense, on a map like Hollywood, because of how wide open the second point is and how important high ground is and waiting for elevators and being able to flank a little bit, that if you don't have really good teamwork and coordination, you end up having these skirmishes of two players here at Saloon and two players on the top of the first houses, and then you got two in the alley, and then when that happens, you're just not going to win these team fights. It just looked really sloppy from NG Red, and similarly, that's what we saw from Splice. But I'm going to guess that the attack right now from Gale Force will be a lot better, and it's going to be pretty rough for NG Red.
Yeah, it looks like we might go back into the lobby in just a second, because no, they're saying just play it out. The kill cams are on, just a little minor thing that usually tournaments have kill cams off, but they're just going to play it out, see how this goes. What are your opinions now that Widowmaker has been nerfed? Obviously, we're seeing her a lot less, but I always thought she performed well attacking on Hollywood here. Do you think she still has a role?
If LG's playing, she still has a role, as Gods is super stubborn about the whole thing and just is forcing Widow back into the meta, but he's really the only one playing it. I think it's just so much less forgiving than some other heroes that you're not getting the value out of her that you used to, and really it's just... A lot of the snipers I've talked to just don't have the preference for Widow anymore. They don't feel as comfortable as they used to. The timing is all off. They haven't had the practice with her yet. So she is pretty much just out of the meta, except in very specific situations. If we do see LG, we'll probably see some Widow. As I said, Gods is like the only one running it, which is funny because LG used to just not have a good Widow player.
Well, Reaver actually ran Widow here on offense on Hollywood. At least one time that they played Hollywood. The majority of the time we are been seeing Farrah across all the maps on offense, and that seems to be the primary option. And then for the main hit scan, it has been Soldier a lot more than Widow. So I think we'll probably see, if we end up seeing Luminosity and or Cloud9 again on Hollywood, it's possible that they use Widow, but more likely it's still going to be Farrah. Chance with a big first kill to open it up does go down after JKW takes out Nap Time, so no Rez is going to be coming out. Nicholas takes out Bird, and it's going to be rough.
That's the fight.
I think the map is going to be over right now. Clean sweep for Gale Force.
Yeah.
Despawn times are really far away. Chance not going to be able to get this, and map one is going to go to Gale Force.
Yeah, it looks like they even stayed on... That's it. Never mind. I was going to add a little thing there, but you know what? It's definitely over. That's too bad. They speed boosted in through security room, and... just walked all over them, complete confidence.
It's a cool angle.
I'm gonna have to question that Red Expert goes Symmetra here. I mean, the purpose of Symmetra, for the most part, is you have an opportunity to hold on first point, but at the same time, you have an opportunity to hold the time as long as possible for point two and point three, because you're able to get teleporter on first point, you're able to extend the time long enough. If NG Red knows that their time on first point was so lackluster, and then an early push in the first one or two or even three team fights from Gale Force is going to win the first map, you can't run Symmetra there trying to, like, make sure that you'd win the map outright by defending checkpoint A or trying to delay the time when it's one which doesn't matter if you're going to lose the first point and lose the map anyway. So that's a mistake for me coming out of NG Red. Red Expert, I think, should have gotten Lucio. We saw what happened when they speed boosted in. They were not able to speed boost out. They weren't even close to getting a teleporter down anyway. And I think it is a lack of not only cohesion coming out of NG Red, but the picks that they're using and even the gameplay that they have, they're not having a big game out of anyone right now. With
you're just being mean. You're just being mean. you're just being a bully right now. Symmetra had the teleporter at the end. I don't disagree with the Symmetra pick. I mean, they had to hold it. I trust in Symmetra. Maybe that's my bias. But she had at the end, they just kind of got wiped. And you can't put that all on her.
You don't expect to lose the first fight that quickly. It rarely happens. I think that's exactly what the strategy was for the offense, though, is let's take a weird angle, surprise them a little bit. Also, that angle does negate a lot of the sentry set up by Symmetra, which is not going to give her the charge that she wants either. So, yeah, I don't necessarily hate the Symmetra pick. I think it's fine because you do need to hold it for pretty long because their first push was awful in a lot of different ways. Their offense was terrible. You know you have to hold that for at least, I think it was 3.5 minutes. So getting the Symmetra up is a huge boon to that. And if you're going to lose the first fight, you're going to lose it anyway. I think it's not necessarily a Symmetra thing there. I think just overall, there's not a ton to say about those games when you're a caster. They just got beat. They just got absolutely stomped. But they're going to try to redeem themselves as we go to Dorado is the map pick.
Now, I thought it was going to be rather even, but I thought that still Gale Force had the advantage going into this match. Now, I really think that Gale Force is, you know, seems like the much better team than NG Red right now. And NG Red's got to get it together on Dorado. And they need to have a much better cohesive offense than they did on Hollywood. Hey. Or especially as we've seen defenses be able to hold on the first point near statue under bridge with someone in lobby and with someone in alley, that NG Red has to be careful here of not having.
Well, Mangachu was saying just before this match that he just woke up and wasn't sure when they were playing. So that might be a little bit of an issue with their team coordination or maybe even how seriously they're taking this, which is unfortunate. But I'd like to see them, like, it's the first game of the day. Huh? You can't expect to win the first game of your day. So I'd like to see them come back and play a little bit stronger here.
You know what? Every team's got to have a first game of the day. You don't win your first game of the day, you go down to losers, and then you don't win that second game of the day, and you miss out on $15,000. And that's how esports works, sir. There are no excuses or reasonings that they could have after that. I mean, everyone has something to say.
They don't need $15,000. They're being generous.
Of course. Just give it away.
I mean, he could have found some time to at least warm up in quick play. I know you guys found the time to warm up in quick play.
Matt Mangashi was playing. He was playing a little bit. So, I mean, he actually played pretty decently, I thought. He got some good picks. He found the teleporter when they needed to on offense. He actually got some kills in the second stage of Hollywood up top. So it is really going to be on Mangashi to do a lot of work here. And Wolf, and especially as we've seen Bird played really well in the last few days, Bird was not as effective in that map as I think we've seen him. And Wolf is going to need to do a lot more in this map if they're going to want to have any chance of winning here.
Yeah, well, we are on Dorado now, and they are going to be playing defense first is NG Red. If Bird stays on this pick, it's going to be one of the more interesting picks because you don't see a ton of Soldier 76 on Dorado. They are going to run a Symmetra, which is absolutely standard on Dorado defense because this walk is so long from spawn to first point here in courtyard defense anyway. So it's Bird on 76, nap time on Mercy. Chance will play Lucio. Bread Expert on that defensive Symmetra. A more standard defensive pick in Mangachu on the Junkrat. And Wolf is going to play the only tank on the roster so far that's going to be Roadhog. But I think Chance is probably going to switch into probably Reinhardt as he's just Lucio to speed boost out the Symmetra here early on. Do you think they run this offensive Hanzo? We've seen some more Hanzo lately.
We have seen Hanzo and Widow on this map, but it really only comes out of LG. And so I'm going to say, like, pretty much no. I just see no chance that happened. And I don't know.
I was hoping we'd see the Wombo combo with the Graviton into...
Yeah, Graviton.
Yeah.
I think more teams... We'll start seeing more teams bring it in, but it's still such a variety pick right now. Hanzo and Widow both in kind of a weird...
Well, this is a pretty standard offense, actually, lately. We're seeing triple tank. Now, you're going to see all three tanks, and Lucio kind of hang out at the bottom, push the arch. Maybe Harblue's going to go on the right, left side, and then Nicholas and Shake are just going to be over the top. Be interesting to see if they come around all the way back. Harblue gets a really early kill on Mangachu. That sucks for them.
Yeah, again, it's starting off with Harblue the same way it started off last time on that solid defense. Nicholas up top, no one able to look up and counter him right now. Wolf is going to need to hit a hook on him, but Wolf is getting focused down by at least three or four players, and they're getting pushed back slowly but surely right here. Nicholas just taking that sky and laying down those super high-damage rockets right now. It doesn't look like there's anything they can do about this.
Brett almost got his teleporter down. He was walking over there. Harblue shut that down immediately. And why I said Mangachu dying that early is awful is because he's the biggest source of damage on this map and in such small choke points. He has his tire up. Now we see a huge transition coming out as Brett Expert switches onto Lucio. Mangachu is going to come up on Reaper. But this offense is pushing so far forward with the combo. Wolf is trying to find an answer to the combo that's been wrecking them. He's going to come up on Widow too. But look at this positioning already from the offense.
Harbor with 4 to 5 big kills to open this game. He is continuing to prove us wrong about anything we said about why, and also his own team not cutting him and making sure he is a valuable part of this roster. They pushed up all the way to the end of the second checkpoint, and now NG Red can't even play forward on the bridge. They are stuck more near the spawn. The payload is right under them. They are going to have to play aggressive off this bridge as Gale Force continues to push the payload.
We have Harblue coming up in the back, popping his ultimate behind everybody. He snuck all the way around, a sneaky little pig in the back, isn't able to get anything. The Mercy hiding for her life. Reinhardt and him are having a tussle back there while the cart is still completely dominated by Gale Force right now, just cleaning up every single person who comes down to try and contest it. It's the Mercy alone with Bird up top, but Nicholas is going to drop the hammer, metaphorically, on everybody. Revives Brett Expert inside the Graviton. He's going to go down. Actually doesn't die for some bizarre reason. Finally now, Mangachu coming in with the Death Blossom, cleaning up some stragglers. They might get a hold here.
Yeah, they should be able to hold this game. The reason he didn't die in that Graviton is because he's Lucio, and Lucio is just insanely difficult to kill.
He is a tank, yeah.
But they have gotten almost nothing out of Wolf so far. The biggest boon he's gotten to this team, actually, is giving them the tactical sights. Yeah, the wall hacks, as we call them here. Bird's able to clean up towards the end, so those are a couple pretty late deaths. This is going to be on Bird to bring this back. It's a decent enough point for 76 to shut down from a distance. Mangachu got a ton of value on his Reaper, so the transition looked a little sloppy early on, but now if you're able to set up with this composition, you can hold this point for a while. And they know that on offense. They're taking a completely different angle, trying to negate some of these damage distance dealers.
They're actually pushing the cart right now while everyone was trying to contest the people in the back. It pulled them away perfectly. Wolf in the back trying to snipe, but Winston's jumping on top of her, and a big Earth Shatter comes down, getting almost no one. I don't actually think I saw it catch anyone. Maybe a Lucio behind the cart. This is not going too well for this offense. God.
How did Naptime die to that? It took Harblue so long to actually get back there and then tickle him down. Not enough support from his team there. It's fine because Shake had died really early and they'd already gotten a bunch of kills, but that's a mistake that you can't have happen early in a fight if it happens again.
Yeah, they do lose two at the end there, but at least NG Red did enough in that early team fight, taking down Shake early on, as you mentioned, that they solidify themselves. They weren't going to lose that. And now they win two team fights in a row. I think that's the first time they've done that this series. And that's going to continue to allow Wolf to set up with Widow on the bridge. And he has wall hacks up again. So Wolf maybe not getting as many kills as he'd want to, but he's still having an okay impact.
Chance, take somebody off the top rope, bring him right down. That's a Reinhardt on the low ground now, going to try and get on top of the cart and see if he can Earth Shatter. The Mercy goes down, Lucio in the back, and this is looking really good again from NG Red. They cleaned that up so perfectly, and I thought that was going to be a good push from Gale Force. They had the high ground, they got really good positioning, and then, Chance just took someone away.
Hit the one shot he had a chance at there, and it was because the attack visor was coming off from Torque. He had Widow in his sights. He was only going to have one shot there. knocked him out, and you're right that he's had a huge impact in this game, Wolf has, and he's made the angles all really awkward for them to come through. His attack bias has been up, and now he's forcing them onto a Widow of their own.
And what we're seeing here is they're actually not coordinating the pushes the same way they had been before. It's just JKW on the point, trying to force some people off the high ground. It's a little bit of a weak push here. They don't seem as organized as they've been in the last couple.
Nicholas goes down early. Chance and Bird with another kill. This time, Shake and Naptime are still alive in the fight, as opposed to the past few fights. Bird with another. Harbu gets one. Harbu gets a second. Finally, the res comes out from Shake and both Naptime. Everyone is full strength again. Mangachu and Harbu trade kills. Torque and JKW, though, with two. It's still a 4-on-3 now on the card. Mangachu with two big kills. Gonna make it a 3-on-3. Still Skirmishing on the card. The spawns favor the defense. NG Red is gonna be able to get back to the cart sooner, but Nap Time does go down to Nicholas, so there is an opportunity here for Gale Force to keep pushing, but it looks like they're going to back off, and NG Red successfully defends a push once again, and that's probably four team fights in a row.
Let's get down on this sniper. The fact that Nicholas has to play Widow because Wolf is just a testament to how much work he's done. Even on the nerf Widowmaker, Mangachu is set up for the Death Blossom of his life here. He's going to come into the back lines right now. There it goes.
Mangachu taking down the end, but enough damage that Chance is finally able to do some work this game. Gets two. Wolf now gets two. Napcon goes down, but it might be okay. Shake is now down two, and Wolf with another. So Wolf doing finally a lot of work on Widow. Chance and Bird followed up. Only Harbu was left alive. See if they had chased him down. He might be able to get out. Actually gets a kill. Parting ways for Harbu, but he's still gonna... No, he does go down in the end to Wolf. So this is six straight team fight wins for NG Red over Gale Force, and you are totally correct. For Wolf to force Nicholas to go Widow versus Widow and to still win the one-on-one duel battle and to be able to do enough damage as he did is testament to what NG Red's able to do right now.
And they need this full hold to give themselves a decent win condition, because they absolutely got rolled through on first point. You rarely see Courtyard go that early in Dorado. It's one of the easier held first points in all of Overwatch, and so they need this first hold to give themselves a chance to not get knocked out of this series.
Yeah, I like it much better that they're taking this high ground again, trying to get the positioning before they come in, but then it looks like they just threw it all away and had to dive down onto the cart before any picks. We are down to 20 seconds left. JKW is getting that cart pushed forward. They need that. Bread Expert trying to contest it, but it looked like things didn't go too much in their favor. We have Shake up top waiting for the revive, just hanging out in the back, taking some pistol shots on Nap Time. Some mercy on mercy action there as everyone else is getting put on the ground. Shake coming in for the revive, but goes down before he's able to pop it.
There's a lot of people having good games for NG Red, but Wolf shut down the two engines of Gale Force, and that is Torque and Nicholas. He forced Nicholas on a Heroes he didn't want to play. He shut down Torque. He shut down several ultimates from the Soldier 76 that was coming out there. I mean, that was Wolf's game on the second half of there. And early on, it looked like a terrible switch, as he did absolutely nothing on the Widow. Once he started getting his rhythm, they got set up. He dominated that game in the second half.
It was such a strong start coming out of Gale Force. Harbu got 4 to 5 big kills. They were able to push the spawn in at the very first set wave of the second checkpoint. That didn't allow Wolf to get set up. They won that first team fight. They pushed the cart all the way to under the bridge. And as soon as NG Red was able to win a very long team fight, that was allow Wolf to set up on bridge and to set up on long to make sure that Gale Force, who attempted 3 to 4 team fights by flanking along from long into upper church onto bridge, and none of them were successful. And a lot of that reason is because Wolf was able to watch that area that entire time, and him along with Bird and that long range hit scan DPS was able to do enough work to keep Gale Force back. And this puts NG Red in such a good position to only need to get second checkpoint to move this to a third map.
And they had to, because they give up first in under a minute, which, again, you just rarely see on Toronto. It's one of the most easily defensible firsts in the game. This defense, though, has looked pretty good from Gale Force the last couple times we've seen them on Toronto, and it's a lot of it has been on Harbly watching the staircase entrance. Anyone who pokes over there and tries to get in on that side, he's absolutely hooked and shut them down. He's going to force the offense to try to run through this main arch, which is not a fun task, because that's going to be Joe Meister spamming orbs. It's going to be fire strikes through there, etc. So I mean, really, their win condition is get it to second point. I don't think they're going to take this first point in under a minute, as they gave it up, so we'll see. But they gave themselves a condition to actually win Dorado and bring this to a third map.
The one thing I will notice is that, again, we will see a defensive Pharah coming out from Nicholas instead of Junkrat, which seems to continue to be the safer pick here on this map, and Nicholas is going to have to do a lot of work.
Yeah. They do have Wolf still switching characters in spawn. Not sure when he wants to go with Hanzo.
I think this is a good decision. He's just able to do so well on defensive Widow that he's in the rhythm. He's playing well. Let him play offense here on Dorado. Let him see if he can get some picks. He is going up against a defensive Pharah, which is why I still don't love defensive Pharah right now. Wolf has an opportunity to make some things happen.
The other thing is, defensive Junkrat is so strong on this map. I mean, one of the reasons they lost first so quickly was because Magnitude was the first death on his defensive Junkrat. Usually, all of your zone defense under this arch makes it almost impossible to push this first arch.
Oh man, he was almost the first death again. I was going to say you need to watch him because Harblue's going to be grabbing him any second. But the Harblue shotgun did not connect, and now we have Magnitude with the damage boost spamming out rockets from up above. But this could go in his favor just because they have Wolf trying to snipe right now. If Nicholas jumps up into the air and really tries to contest this Pharah, he's probably going to get sniped. Wolf finding some angles on the side, but Harblue throwing out the hook, making him a little bit cautious about the shots he's going for. No one really fitting anything yet.
This is one of the advantages that NG Red has right now. Because there's no Junkrat to spam stairs, a Wolf is able to kill Shake. This is going to open up the map for them.
Huge.
There's going to be no mercy for Nicholas to heal. This is the opportunity for NG Red to push forward. Magnitude is going to go to the side. Wolf is continuing to take pot shots on stairs. NG Red being a little bit hesitant here. They are giving some time to Shake to get back to respawn. They still have some time. 6-on-5. Shake is not back yet. Magnitude and Naptime finally get some damage in. Shake is almost back to spawn. Magnitude does get the kill. JKW is down. It is going to be a 6-on-4 still. Shake is finally back. Nicholas goes down. 6-on-3. Finally a takeout Wolf. The nap time actually goes down. So there's no mercy now for NG Red. It was looking so good for NG Red. Shake comes in.
No. Hunter
with one. JKW with another. Nicholas comes back after being rezzed. And NG Red, who had such a good shot with a 6-on-5 and then a 6-on-4 to take at least to the statue.
That fight took way too long. They got a couple picks, and then they just kind of stood around the cart. They were able to get up the teleporter. I think that's what we saw really coming in for the win there, is they had the teleporter up, even though they had the pick on Shake. He was back before that fight ended.
I mean, I don't know why, when you know that the opponent Mercy is down, and you don't just start going super aggro and just sack in, and because any death is going to be cleaned up, and then even by the time the other Mercy gets back, you'll probably have a second res charge. It's absolutely a free second life that they took zero advantage of.
Yeah, NG Red, as soon as they got Mercy, should have been aggressive. Magnitude didn't go in with nap time on the left side at Stairway.
Even Magnitude can just go in alone. I mean, you want to save nap time, right? Because you want to get that res advantage. But like the fact that everyone didn't just push in and just start going as ham and doing as much damage as possible, taking repositions to get resed in good positions, a huge mistake. There's no other way to say it. Hardly taken out early by Bird.
Magnitude coming in, but the sentry turrets behind him are able to take him down. It looks like we had a Reinhardt try to go to the back, and again, they're cleaned up. We need to see like a little bit of a flank here, maybe. Even Magnitude flying over that wall in the back to get the teleporter before they can even consider winning this fight.
Yeah, I mean, 3 minutes have gone by, and there's only been 2 team fights in the map so far, and now the Gale Force has gotten teleported down. Magnitude has to go on a mission and go get that, and they still cannot let Harblue continue to get the first picks out of all of these team fights. NG Red has to make more decisive decision making. Harbu does find the Pharah, kills Magnitude first off, JKW with another, and it's only gonna get worse for NG Red in this team fight. Gale Force cleaning things up. Chance and Magnitude with 2 kills on their own, but a res coming out. from Gale Force, and it's not going to be good for NG Red.
I mean, I totally agree with you, Star, that they should be coming around over this right flank, which is a strategy we've seen work on Dorado time and again, even during the Widow meta, that you send your combo up over the right at the very least. I mean, yes, now you have to worry about taking on the teleporter, but at the very least, it creates space under the arch so that your four can get in up front without getting bullied out early on, and then you put them in a different position. If you have the defense with six eyes facing the arch, there's no way you can push through it. At the very least, Mangachu and Naptime coming over the right side would open up some space for them in the courtyard.
Geo Meister with a ball from like the entire across the map, killing Bird, is going to force NG Red back again. They're going to have to wait even further. Nicholas with a direct rocket, and they're just delaying NG Red. And NG Red looks very tentative right now. They only have 30 seconds to get to the first checkpoint.
Yeah, well, this switch comes a little late from Wolves.
Yeah, Harpoon on the side again takes out Mangachu before this fight even really begins. A gigantic revive though of three players, able to finally start getting a fight going. They're gonna need to remember that the teleporter is still back there. Probably has at least two or three charges on it yet.
And they're not paying attention to the teleporter. It's not even gonna matter. They're losing the team fight. It's 2-on-2. Wolf is still alive. And Bread Expert is finally able to get the kill, but they never found the teleporter.
Yeah, three people just came out of it right now. That's what I'm saying. Three charges left on it. Shake is back. We have a full defense ready again. If they're going to be able to push it now, they have to do it now. Wolf isn't really seen quite yet. Takes down Torque. He's the last hope. He's in Wraith form. Lets his teammates come in from the back. Mangachu flying above. They might actually be able to get this right now. It would be kind of a miracle if they were. But JKW puts him on the ground. And puts
there getting some work done.
Huge Earth Chatter from Wolf, Chance, and Mangachu killing NG Red. Gale Force. And Gale Force got everyone through the teleporter, and NG Red is going to extend this into second checkpoint. They are still able to win this map, send it to a third map. Gale Force had everything they needed at the end, but Chance actually was a big plays and the counter at Earth Chatter to win that team fight.
Yeah, I thought the switch was late, but now it doesn't matter that Wolf is coming on the Reaper. I love the switch into it, especially if you're not going to take these flanking routes and you're trying to open up space. If you're just going to try to bully frontline, Reaper is a great frontliner to deal with both Harblue and JKW, who've been stalling out a lot of these pushes. There goes
another big hook from Harblue. Harblue has gotten the opening pick
on Mangachu games every time. It's always Mangachu.
Nap time goes down, and Gale Force is going to be pushing back NG Red in a clean 6-0 team fight win. That's going to give them ult advantage into these next fights. And even though NG Red was miraculously able to get the checkpoint, they only have 2 minutes left to get this one. Now, they only need to get the checkpoint to win the map, so they still have some time. But the card is still so far back that they are going to need to push it up some. They have three players going to the flank, but Harp was playing aggro again in his nap time. Oh, he barely misses the kill. That's going
to
give NG Red
a rocket that boosted him to the side. He wasn't able to line up the shotgun, but again, Harblu has done so good at initiating these fights.
Look at all these ults, though. Offense has everything they want. Here comes the big barrage. Takes down Nicholas up top. Brad Expert takes down JKW. I mean, the Rez is going to come in.
I think we just saw the play of the game, Rez, with all of them. Harblu pushing the people off the ground, cleaning up after Reinhardt's charge each other. Oh, massive fight right there. Harblue's one of the last people left standing defending the point. He's probably going to come out here and try and get a hook on Bird in a second. It's just them. But Naptime flies in. Naptime has a revive, but all of the people have respawned already.
Bird pushing the card by itself. Harblue's not able to get the kill. Naptime still has res because he died in the last fight. Wolf is actually going to go in on Harblue. He's going to try it. If he gets bounced around, Wolf has to go back. The cart is being pushed forward. They only need one team fight to secure the map victory. Naptime dies in the very beginning. Harbu gets the pick. They're going to have a merciless fight for NG Red. Wolf gets one kill, and the sound barrier comes in late for Gale Force, not able to save JKW. And they're not able to get any kills off the sound barrier, finally, from Harbu. But NG Red still pushing the cart. 30 seconds to go. They will have one more opportunity for a last.
I think that really came down to, they couldn't deal with Nicholas up in the air. They have Reapers on the point. They didn't have anything that could really shoot up and stop him. He was just dealing out nonstop, consistent damage. Mangachu wasn't there for the end of that fight, and it looks like they're going to have a...
This is only 10 seconds. They're going to have to touch the cart, but they have one last opportunity. Nap time with ult, Mangachu with ult, Chance with ult, and Bread Expert might be able to get Sound Barrier in time. Wolf is going to be able to... And Harbu kills Nap time again to start the fight. Mangachu kills three, but it is 6-on-4, and there's no way They're going to be able to do this. 6-on-2, Harbu and Nicholas turn it around. So Harbu MVP.
Yeah,
four,
easily. That last push was coming in, so Harbu was hiding with his giant fat street pig, and no one saw him. He's crouching around the corner, and then the last one in on that fight, of course, going to be Naptime, who gets hooked out, cleaned up in the back, no resurrection for that last fight, and that's it.
Harbu was,
yeah, this play of the game, that big four-man revive.
I mean, that was actually huge, too, because that allowed Gale Force to win that team fight as well. So, I mean, but really, along with some great plays, some Shake, Harbu, so many opening picks on both Mangachu, and then at the end, two in a row in the clutch situations against Naptime, securing that victory.
It's actually interesting. It could have gone the other way. Harbu is always on a weird flank alone, just a pig trying to hook somebody, and no one ever really capitalized on it. No one surrounded him. It was always him versus Mangachu with the Mercy behind him, and his team was never really with him. So right. They could have had that the opposite way. They could have gotten Harbu pick and started off fights that way strong, but never really seemed to work out that way for them.
Yeah, and that's on Wolf, but it's got to be Wolf on his Reaper to be able to deal with Harbu. I mean, it's the only really strong counter to Roadhog right now is a really nice Reaper, and then that also feeds your Reaper alt, too. You get everything going for you. I thought the pick onto Reaper was a little bit too late, and then also just never able to capitalize on Harbu trying to go super flanky, because really they were just desperate to get people on the card and into fights. You can't really be worried about your flanks as often as they would have liked to when they only have 2 minutes to finish out the map. But that is it. That is going to be Gale Force beating NG Red. And our next map up for on this stream, anyway, is going to be Splice versus Liquid.
Dude, we're
going
to have AZK versus Steel in Overwatch. Everyone better be hyped for that. That is actually an insane matchup to have. But really, just to finish off the thoughts for this series, Gale Force looked like the better team. Even though they had some problems in the middle of Dorado, especially on offense, they were not even able to get the second checkpoint. They looked a little bit lost, trying to always flank around on the side. They still had the better team fights overall. They still had the better compositions overall, and they did look like the more solid team. For NG Red, while there was some solid play coming out from Mangachu, and I think Wolf played pretty decently on defense for Widow, especially in the second half, that's not enough for them to be able to win these games, especially versus the top teams in the world. And they really do look like they're kind of lost.
They seemed a little bit stubborn. Things clearly weren't working, and there weren't very many character changes. You saw them push against that Area 1 defense on Dorado for so long before trying to go for the teleporter. They only switched Wolf onto Reaper because that wasn't working, but it was just the same thing over and over again, not working up until the end where things just clicked for some reason.
I think it's about decision making. I mean, not only did they have those opportunities at the beginning of Dorado to take the fight when they had a 6-on-5, 6-on-4, including killing Mercy that early, and you have Rez before the other Mercy, and then being so tentative and not playing the advantage there shows some inconsistencies, along with, I feel you're right, that there is a lack of changes. And I think that's because of they don't have as many compositions down together as other teams, and that their players are not able to switch into as many heroes as other teams. And as I've talked about before, you know, to beat the top teams in the world, you need to be able to flex into several different things, especially the flex support into tank and flex support into DPS.
I don't think they used any Zarya. I think that would have made a huge difference just to stop Harbu, who was such a clear problem that they were dealing with, if they had a Zarya watching Mangachu all the time, because he was getting pulled at the beginning of every fight, and then you could capitalize on that Harbu and swing that momentum forward. Even on Hollywood Defense 1, we saw them several times trying the same thing and getting stopped the same way, not even just character switches. I think maybe it could be like a main caller issue that they really weren't deciding to do anything new, that they just had one strategy and they stuck to it a little bit too strongly.
Well, I mean, I agree with both your points, actually, because if you're going to invest in that one strategy, which is clearly their combo play, that they never switched off the Pharah and Mercy, that they're going to run that no matter what, then why not fully invest in it with Azaria and give her the allied shield?
Yeah, I mean, it makes
a lot of
sense.
If you're going to be jumping over the top, we used to see it against Widowmakers a lot, too, that if you're going to try to run a Pharah against a Widowmaker, you better be giving her a shield all the time or you're not going to be able to do it at all. And really, I mean, oddly enough, Roadhog has filled the Widowmaker role in a lot of different ways, and a lot of it is shutting down the Pharah, so... I completely agree with you that Azaria pick, I think, is good in every composition personally. But if you're going to really doggedly stick on running a Pharah and you're getting plucked out of the sky, which they had for two maps in a row now, then give her a little help. If you're going to stick with it and it's not working, find a way to fix what you're going to stick with or just switch. So I think Azaria would have been great there. And clearly the problem was Harblue. You can solve that in a way, either killing him or just negating his biggest asset in that hook. And they did neither. And that's why they lost that match.
Azaria is just such a good pick now with...